My name is Adio M.O., the corresponding author of this paper. I'm presenting this paper titled Determinants of Income from Small-Scale Cassava Processing Activities in Ogoluwa Local Government Area of Gomos Oyo State. Introduction. Cassava is a very important crop to Nigeria. Its comparative production advantage over other staples serves to encourage its cultivation even by the resource-poor farmers. The cross production is generally thought to require less labor per unit of output than other major staples. For the large population of Nigeria depends on cassava daily as their main dish, such as garri, fufu, pupuru, and starch. The leaves are consumed as vegetables and it serves as raw material to industry, as well as being a means of alleviating poverty. In spite of the various uses cassava is known for, as an agent of self-sufficiency in food production, the gain derived from its production by rural farmers is still not sufficient to keep this resource of poor farmers above the poverty line. Farmers tend to be unemployed during the dry season, of which the period is usually used for processing activities. Fresh cassava roots cannot be stored for long because they rot within 3 to 4 days of harvest. It is therefore now crucial to make deliberate attempt to develop strategies that will add value to the farm product to increase their shelf lives, reduce post-harvest losses, and shore up the national capacity to meet the food needs of the Nigerian people. Specifically, this paper examines the socio-economic characteristics of cassava processors and the determinants of income from cassava processing activities in the study area. The hypothesis is stated in all form that socioeconomic characteristics of the respondent do not have any significant effect on income from small-scale cassava processing. The methodology. The analytical methods used are descriptive statistics and regression analysis. The descriptive statistics was used to examine the socioeconomic characteristics of the respondent in the study area. The ordinary least square regression was used to estimate the determinant of income among cassava processors in the study area. This is the model. Y is the dependent variables and the X to X8 are the independent variables. Results and discussions. Table 1 is showing the frequency distribution of socioeconomic characteristics of the respondent. From the table, we can see that the mean age was 53.7 years. About 61.8% of the processors have no formal education, and the processing method mostly available are the local and modern method, but the processors in the study area majority use traditional methods. Table 2 showing us the regression results. The significant variables are the age, education, initial capital, labor cost, maintenance cost at 1% and 5% respectively. This implies that the initial capital, labor cost, and years of schooling were positive and statistically significant at 5%, 1%, and 1% respectively. This means implies that additional increase in invested capital will lead to 5.08 increase in labor. Likewise, the more educated the processor is, the better. The null hypothesis was thereby rejected because there were significant levels of relationship between the socioeconomic characteristics and the incomes of the processors. In conclusion, it was concluded that cassava processing in the study area is profitable. Some of the problems identified should therefore be addressed by the government of Nigeria and processing stakeholders. Thank you for listening.